Hi, my name is Ellen Brennan. I am the oncology nurse navigator, and I facilitate the Siteman Lung Cancer Screening Program at Barnes Jewish St. Peter's and Progress West. So just a couple things about lung cancer screening that helps me understand it is low-dose chest CT is to lung cancer screening as mammography is to breast cancer. So it just kind of helps me in my mind understand it. If a physician orders you, your patient, a family member to have a lung cancer screening, it does not mean that they're concerned that they have lung cancer. So just remember that screening are tests that are given before there's any signs or symptoms. Lung cancer is the second most common cancer in men and women. Breast cancer is most common in women, and prostate cancer is most common in men. But each year, more people die from lung cancer than breast cancer, colon cancer, and prostate cancer combined. So one reason that lung cancer is so serious, usually by the time patients have symptoms of lung cancer, it means that it's already spread to other organs. So it's vitally important to catch lung cancer as early as we can. Now we have new treatments for stage one lung cancer, and we have stereotactic radiation, we have ablation and surgery, different kinds of surgery. Chest x-ray is no longer recommended for lung cancer screening. In the past, chest x-rays were done for lung cancer screening, but now low-dose CTs are recommended. It usually takes less than a minute. They get lots of images of your lungs. It's very important to have it followed up, though, so at least every year you need to come back to have it checked for any kind of new nodules, assess any growth or changes. And now that you know about it, you want to know who are at high risk for lung cancer. If you're between the ages of 55 and 80, current or former smoker, which is very important, even if you're a former smoker and have quit within the past 15 years, you are eligible for lung cancer screening. You have to have smoked at least a pack a day for 30 years or two packs a day for 15 years or something equivalent, and have no symptoms of lung cancer. So now you know you meet criteria, what next? So you want to go and talk to your physician. It can be your primary care doctor, pulmonologist, cardiologist. You want to get an order for a low-dose chest CT for lung cancer screening. Most insurance companies, almost all of them, now cover it under preventative health. So it's very important, though, you want it to have lung cancer screening. Once you have that order, you want to make sure you take it to an accredited facility. And an accredited facility is a facility that has a nurse navigator like myself. We also have radiologists that are dedicated to reading the low-dose chest CTs. We also have a group of physicians, and we work together as a multidisciplinary team. So if there is anything that shows up on the CAT scan, we're here to help the patient get through the next process. So smoking cessation. 50% of people who have lung cancer are smokers. Out of that 50%, this was very surprising to me, 83% of them continue to smoke, because at that point they figure, you know, I might as well keep on smoking, I have lung cancer. But that's not true at all. Actually, quitting smoking, it will increase your appetite. It increases activity level. It helps you sleep better. So those are all reasons. It also can decrease the possibility of getting a secondary lung cancer or the current lung cancer going to other parts of your body. So smoking cessation is obviously important for everybody. We all know that it's important to quit smoking. We currently have a program at Barnes Jewish St. Peter's called Beat the Pack, which I'm very excited about. It is very low pressure. We don't pressure anybody, because one of the things that I found about smoking cessation, that's it's usually the anticipation of quitting smoking that scares people the most. So this is very low pressure. There's no charge, but you must register. 4 weeks long, and it's going to be a continuous. So we have 4 weeks, we have a week off, and then four more weeks. You are welcome to come as much or as little as you like. So please, if you have any questions at all about smoking cessation or about early detection lung cancer and are having trouble getting an order, or you're having trouble with the insurance company, please call me. I am at 636-916-7098. Thank you very much.